Hey guys, today we'll discuss about regulation of blood pressure. So, how blood pressure is regulated? Before going to regulation of blood pressure, we will discuss the importance of blood pressure in our body, right? So, what is blood pressure? First thing, right? So, let's take a blood vessel. Blood vessel means it can be an artery, it can be a vein, right? So, it has something called blood in it. So, blood pressure is a simple thing, the pressure exerted by the blood on the vessel wall. So, this is the wall of the blood vessel, right? So, the pressure exerted by the blood vessel on the, by the blood. So, this is called blood pressure, right? So, what is the importance of blood pressure, right? My body organs continuously receiving the blood, which is oxygenated. Means, what is the importance of the blood supply? Means, the blood supply should be there because to maintain the normal function of the body, right? So to maintain that, blood has to be flowing in a normal flow. If the pressure is decreased, the flow will be decreased. So that is the importance of the blood pressure in our body. We'll discuss majorly about regulation of the blood pressure. So how blood pressure is regulated in the body, right? So first thing, let's take a condition where there is a decreased blood pressure, right? So decreased blood pressure, what will happen? We have some nervous system called autonomic nervous system. It will stimulate sympathetic nervous system, right? So how the sympathetic nervous system is stimulated? The sympathetic nervous system is stimulated by baroreceptors. Where the baroreceptors are located? They are located in the arch of the aorta. So these baroreceptor, what is a baro? Baro means pressure. So whenever pressure is decreased, the receptor will stimulate, and that stimulation will lead to the activation of sympathetic activity. So when sympathetic activity is activated, what will happen? We have some receptor called beta 1 receptor. So sympathetic system act by adrenoreceptor, that includes alpha and beta adrenoreceptors, right? So these beta 1 adrenoreceptors are in my heart. So the activation of beta 1 adrenoreceptors will lead to what happens? This activation of beta 1 adrenoreceptor, which are located in the heart, those activation will lead to increased cardiac output. What will happen whenever the stimulation of beta 1 receptors takes place? The heart start to contract more. When heart start to contract more, what will happen? Cardiac output is increased. When cardiac output is increased, the blood pressure will automatically increase, right? So this is one type of mechanism, and I told you alpha receptor also located. So this sympathetic activity will lead to the stimulation of alpha 1 adrenoreceptors, which are located in our blood vessels. So whenever my blood vessels are located, it will lead to two things. One is increased venous return, right? So what is venous return? Venous return is nothing but the quantity of blood which is coming back to the heart. Means whenever the alpha 1 adrenoreceptors, which are located in the smooth muscles of blood vessel, are stimulated, blood vessel will start to contract. So that vasoconstriction will lead to increased venous return, that will lead to increased cardiac output, and that will lead to elevation of BP. And one more thing, they also increase resistance. So what do I mean by increase of resistance? What will happen? Let's take, this is a blood vessel. It will make vasoconstriction. So the normal blood vessel was like this. Whenever alpha 1 was stimulated, the blood vessel is narrowed. So that will lead to resistance, increased resistance, that will lead to elevation of blood pressure, right? So this is one mechanism by stimulation of adrenoreceptors, right? So beta 1 adrenoreceptors also located in kidney. Right, so how kidney will involve, we'll discuss now, right? So whenever I was telling you earlier, the decreased blood pressure will lead to decreased blood flow to the organ. Whenever blood flow is decreased, what happens to kidney's blood flow? Decrease of kidney, that is renal blood flow. So this renal blood flow decrease, what will happen? It will stimulate the formation of renin. So whenever renal blood flow is decreased, that will stimulate the formation of renin from the the extraglomerular apparatus, right? Also, the stimulation of beta 1 receptors in the kidney, they also lead to the increased production of renin, right? So this renin, it will form angiotensin 1, right? So this angiotensin 1 is further converted into angiotensin 2. So this angiotensin 2, it will increase the resistance. Means what it will do? It will cause vasoconstriction. So this vasoconstriction will lead to increased blood pressure, right? So there is one more mechanism. What will happen? This angiotensin 2 will increase aldosterone level. So what is the function of aldosterone level? So aldosterone is stimulated. I mean the level of aldosterone is increased. What will happen? Increased sodium and water, right? So increased sodium and water in the body. Whenever sodium water is increased, what will happen? The volume of the blood will increase. So that volume of the blood increase will lead to increased blood pressure. So whenever I am having decreased blood pressure, it will activate all these mechanisms. So these many mechanisms are involved in our regulation of blood pressure, right? So what is the importance of this concept? Because to understand antihypertensive pharmacology, it is a very, very important key. Because the drugs, whatever work as antihypertensive, they are involved in somewhere over here. So this is the regulation of the blood pressure in our body. Thank you. Keep following.